It was supposed to be a family event. Fireworks, cotton candy, stuffed toys. That is why so many of the victims were children. 16-year-old Kimberly Torres was separated from her mother in the chaos. I didn't understand what was happening, she told us. I saw the truck and I went closer and then I saw everyone lying on the ground. I started running because everyone else was running too, but I still didn't understand. She can't finish talking to us. She starts to cry. And then her mother says, she's going to be 17 soon. And she called me and she said, Mommy, there are dead people everywhere. There are severed heads, dismembered legs, blood. Mommy, come get me, she said. So I left in a panic to look for her. And I tried to stay strong. I didn't want to cry in front of her. But I just can't hold back anymore. Her leg was injured in the stampede to escape, but she was lucky. At least three children remain in critical care, one still unidentified. In all, some 50 children were brought here. For many, their parents have not been found. Now, this is the promenade where the attack happened, and as you can see, people have been leaving flowers here all day. The truck actually started its attack right around the bend there. And the closest hospital to the scene is the Lonval Children's Hospital right there. Doctors told us they rushed in expecting many of the wounded to be brought in, but they had no idea just how many of those wounded would be children.
These were not the wounds we saw in Brussels or Paris, says Dr. Christian. These were massive blunt trauma injuries, run over, crushed beneath the truck. Something you would see in a car crash, but to have 50 children brought in from a car accident all at once is very, very rare. Dozens of children are still in this hospital, barely able to grasp the trauma that will remain with them for the rest of their lives. Atika Shubert, CNN, Nice, France.